knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Let us dive further into the phylum Basidiomycota, specifically in the class Agaricomycetes and the order Agaricales. In the previous tutorial, we discussed a number of species in the family Agaricaceae. Over the next few tutorials, we will discuss many more species and families within the order Agaricales. By doing so, we will see examples of fungi that encompass a wide range of the possible mushroom-forming species found in nature. In the order Agaricales, most of the gilled mushrooms include species like Amanita muscaria, the fly agaric, and the white button mushroom Agaricus bisporus. In this tutorial, we will be discussing gilled mushrooms from the following families: Inocybeaceae, Strophariaceae, and Hymenogastraceae. First, we will discuss the genus Inocybe, which have their own family, Inocybeaceae. Inocybe is a large genus consisting of thousands of different species of small brown, gray, or yellowish mushrooms, with some purple exceptions. Generally, these mushrooms require microscopy of spores and cystidia to identify to the species level, so we will focus on the general characteristics of the entire genus. The Greek root ino from Inocybe means fibrous, which references the lacerated or fibrous pattern that appears on many of the species' caps. The caps are conical, often having a pronounced central umbo. Many of the species have a noticeable odor, ranging from sweet and fruity to smelling unpleasantly fishy. In addition to producing repulsive odors, most inocybes are poisonous. They contain a toxin called muscarine, which can lead to death at certain amounts. Next, let's discuss the family Strophariaceae. These are gilled mushrooms that produce red-brown to dark-brown spores. Under a microscope, the spores have a glabrous or smooth surface with an apical germ pore. The gills are attached to the stipe. The Greek root stroph means belt, which indicates the presence of a partial veil on many species in Strophariaceae. These mushrooms form in clusters and are saprobic, meaning they feed on dead organic matter like leaf litter or decaying wood. We will discuss important species from three genera in the family Strophariaceae: Strophariaceae, Hypholoma, and Pholiota. Strophariaceae rugoso-annulata, the king's Strophariaceae, or the wine cap, is a large edible mushroom that is usually found breaking down wood chips. So this fungus is relatively easy to cultivate for consumption. It has a wine-red cap color when young that fades to yellow-beige when old. The gills transition from pale gray to purplish gray as they age and produce a purple-brown spore print. The stipe is white to yellow-white. The species name Rugoso annulata is derived from two Latin roots, rugos, meaning wrinkly, and annulus, which means ring. So this species has a wrinkly partial veil. Historically, Strophariaceae rugoso annulata was cultivated alongside corn to enhance the soil nutrient composition and growing conditions. The hyphae of this species have specialized cells that can kill nematodes, which are microscopic worms. The next species, Hypholoma fasciculare, the sulfur-tuft mushroom, is a fungus that forms tightly packed clusters on decaying wood. The genus name Hypholoma originates from the Greek root hyph, meaning thread. This references the thread-like remnants of the partial veil that are on the margin of the cap. The species epithet is fasciculare, which is derived from the Latin root fascia, which means bundles, and describes the clusters that sulfur tufts form. If you were to take a small bite out of the cap and spit it out, it would have an intensely bitter taste. If you were to instead swallow a substantial amount of the mushrooms, you would have severe nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. The gills produce a purplish-brown spore print, and the gill color is yellow, turning darker as they age. Sulfur tufts are widely distributed around the world, but are notably found in England and the west coast of North America. Next, let's discuss mushrooms in the genus Pholiota, which gets its namesake from the Greek root phol, which means scale. The type species, meaning the species that mycologists have chosen to represent a genus, is Pholiota squarosa, or the shaggy scaly cap. The mushroom received this name because both the cap and stipe of the mushroom are covered with pointed scales. The mushroom is saprobic and is an opportunistic parasite among a diverse number of trees. An opportunistic parasite can only infect a tree when it is already weakened by a previous infection from bacteria or other fungi. All Pholiota species are considered white rot fungi, which describes fungi that only break down the lignin of wood, leaving the white fibrous cellulose. Another type of wood decay is brown rot, which breaks down the cellulose, leaving only crumbly brown lignin. Pholiota squarosa can produce combinations of smells of garlic, radish, and lemon. Another important species of Pholiota is Pholiota microspora, or the Nameko mushroom. Widely cultivated in Japan, Nameko has a delicious nutty flavor and a gelatinous layer on the cap that acts as a thickening agent for stir fries or miso soup. The mushroom is suspected to have medicinal benefits as well. Now that we have covered some of the diversity in the family Strophariaceae, let's move on to a genetically similar family, Hymenogastraceae. Originally, this family only housed species of false truffles from the genus Hymenogaster. However, since the addition of genetic analysis, some infamous gilled mushrooms have been moved to this family. We will discuss two important genera in Hymenogastraceae, Galerina and Psilocybe. Let's begin with the genus Galerina. All Galerina species are saprobic, but many species are found in association with mosses. The caps of these mushrooms are typically brown, glabrous, and hygrophonous. The gills will be attached and produce variable brown spore prints. The spores of many Galerina species have a distinct feature where a part of the outer covering is incomplete, leaving a clear patch called a plage. The most infamous species of Galerina is Galerina marginata, or the deadly Galerina. This little brown mushroom grows in clusters on wood. It contains amatoxins, which in very small doses cause extreme liver and kidney damage. Generally, poisonings from this species occur after mistaking the mushroom for a species from the genus Psilocybe. This genus, commonly known as magic mushrooms, is an iconic group of gilled mushrooms famous for their hallucinogenic properties. Psilocybe species are similar to Galerina species, as they are generally small and brown with a hygrophonous cap and produce variable brown spore prints. This genus is found throughout the world in a variety of habitats and is saprobic on a number of different substrates. A key identifying characteristic is a blue staining reaction when the fruiting body is bruised. This staining is caused by the oxidation of a molecule called psilocybe. This molecule gets broken down into a similar molecule called psilocin, which is the source of the hallucinogenic properties of these mushrooms. Psilocybe is the subject of much research in the field of ethnomycology, which studies historical uses and sociological impacts of fungi. Psilocybe is also beginning to generate research for its potential use as a therapy for anxiety and depressive psychological disorders. Let's now move on to some other areas of the order Agaricales.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.